everyone, welcome to Streaming Every Day. In this video, we will learn how to install Kaltura's Nginx VOD module and what is Nginx. Nginx is an HTTP and reverse proxy server, mail proxy server, and a generic TCP UDP proxy server. And to read more about it, you will have to go to this link. I will post it in the description, or you can just Google it and you will find this webpage. And what is the Nginx VOD module? It is basically the video on demand module, as the name suggests. It has many features, so to know about it, we have to Google it again, and we can find a GitHub page from Kaltura Nginx VOD module. And for that, if you Google, you will find something like this. Just to give you a general reference, although it enables on-the-fly repackaging of MP4 files to -HDS, HLS, and MSS. There are several other features as well, like DRM encryption, multi-bitrate, subtitles, and many more that are supported by this module. So you will have to read this readme thing, and then you will understand why it is very important for a media engineer actually. And yeah, so we will learn how to install this. The installation is given here on this page. The procedure is given very nicely, but the problem was most of my colleagues couldn't install using these instructions. They had always issues with some version mismatch or something like this, so I decided to make a custom solution for this. And all I did was gathered some different resources, like people's experiences with installation, and then just found out a way to install it. So let's start with the installation. We will have to go to the terminal for it. Now keep in mind, I'm using an Ubuntu VM 20.04. I'm using the virtual machine, but you can also just do it on your operating system. But this installation is specifically for Ubuntu 20.04. Please keep that in mind. If you face any problem in installation, just write it down in the comments and I will help you there. So let's start. I will make the terminal bigger. And let me also increase the size. Alright, I think this would be fine. So first and foremost, we have to make sure we operate the terminal as root, because we have to make sure that we have no permission issue on the installation and configuration. And for that, we will write sudo su. If you are already operating it as root, then you don't have to worry. But yeah, I have to make it to the root user, so yeah. And yeah, next thing will be installing the dependencies, the Nginx dependencies. So I have all the commands in my clipboard, but I can put it in the description, don't worry. And yeah, so let's start. I will paste these dependencies here, and it will take some time depending on your operating system and how fast your system is. So yeah, I will just select yes, and then it goes on further. For me, it took very less time, so yeah, it's not that these dependencies are not that big, so don't worry. And yeah, I'll clear this. So the next thing would be to install Nginx source code, and for that you will have to go to the Nginx website to download the binaries. And yeah, here we have different versions. So I am using Nginx 1.20.2 because I know it's compatible with the version that I want to install of Nginx VOD module. So make sure the version is compatible with the VOD module. For me, it was good enough, like the features were also good enough, so that's why I installed 1.20.2, sorry. So yeah, so I just wget it. You can also just clone it from GitHub. So here we are, we have the Nginx folder, so we have to open this folder now. So again, I have the command in my clipboard, I will just paste it because it saves some time. There you go. So I just unzipped it and let me clear it. Okay, so now we have the source code, right? The next thing would be to download the Kaltura VOD module. Now, how to get the Kaltura VOD module? I already have a command where I have the link and I will just wget it. But what you can do is go back to the browser and the page that you opened. If you're not, then you can open it and you can just clone it from GitHub, right? Now I will be using version 1.29 of Kaltura VOD module, but you can choose whatever the latest version or whichever version you prefer for your work. I don't know what you would be doing with the VOD module, but yeah, I am using version 1.29. Again, I will just wget it, and once I do that, I will get again, I think, a zip file, and I will just open it. There it is, 1.29.dar.gz. Okay, I will just open it, unzip it, I mean, and yeah. So let me clear it. Good. Now let me get this present working directory because we will need this next. Okay, so we need to write the configure command right now, where we specify the flags and the paths of the files. So I have this in my clipboard. Okay, so now here for the add module flag, we need to specify the exact path. Make sure you do that because there might be issues later on because of this. And once I do this, I run it. Okay, so there is an error because we are in the wrong folder. Let's go to the correct directory. Now make sure you are in the Nginx directory for this. And now when we run the command, it will start the configuration part. Good. This won't take much time, but the next step might, that is make and make install. So we write that make and make install, and this might take time, but not that much, but a little bit. And once you will be done with this, then we will have the Nginx installed. But it's not done yet completely because we will have to do the server configuration. But let's check if Nginx is installed or not. So for that, we have to type Nginx minus capital V, and that will give us the Nginx version installed, if it is. And there you go. Okay, so we have to check if Nginx VOD module is there, and it will be there if this add module flag is given. Good. Next thing will be to write the nginx.service file, because that is very important to start Nginx. And I will just do nano lib systemd in system nginx.service. Don't worry, it's all in the description. And again, we have paste some things that we need for the service file, and it will make things very easier, trust me. And okay, so now we have to write system control daemon reload. That's it. So now we are done with the nginx.service file. Next thing is the config file. So we do go to cd etc nginx folder, and then we want the backup also, because again it will help us in the longer term. So for that we can do move nginx config and nginx config old like a backup. And now we will create our nginx config file. For that we do nano again nginx config. Good. So here we have to paste again something that you will copy from my clipboard, and you can do it from the description. Good. So once you have this, we are almost ready to configure it. Okay, so these are things that you might want to know. For that you will have to read the documentation, but it's just something that we require for the VOD module, like the headers and which manifest files we need, some stuff like this. Okay, so now the VOD module should be ready to test, as in that we can run Nginx, which will have the VOD module installed. So we do systemctl start nginx.service. Okay, we get an error. So to check what is the error, let's do system control status nginx.service. Okay, so we see that there is an error called address already in use. Okay, I know this because I am running Nginx on my local system, because this is the virtual machine and Nginx is already running, so it's interfering with the socket. So I will just kill it. You can also try out these commands like apache control stop. Maybe that is interfering with the socket. I will just kill any open instance of Nginx running. I have a command for it. Okay, let me paste it. Good. So now if I start Nginx, it should run. Let me clear this and show you. Good. So now when we try, it should run. Okay, no problem. Let's check the status. It will show us that it's running. Good, it's running. Now if we want to check it, we have to just log into the IP address. This is my VM's IP address, so I don't have to worry. And that's how you install Nginx. See you in the next video, where we will learn how to configure it to run a manifest file or any video that you have in different adaptations. And yeah, see you in the next one. Thank you.